Welcome to Midnight Yell Practice, right back in our home, Kyle Field. We want to start tonight by recognizing some very special guests who are joining us here. The 2021-2022 Parents of the Year, Kathy and Reggie Lepley. The Lepleys are proud members of the Aggie family, have been avid supporters of Fightin' Texas Aggie football, and they're the shining example of what it should be, of what we should strive to be as former students. Their love, their commitment and support, not only for Aggie football, but students like us, is second to none. How about a warm Aggie welcome to the 2021-2022 Parents of the Year. Good to see you guys.
Thank you guys.
Now tomorrow, our Fightin' Texas Aggies and the Wrecking Crew defense take on the New Mexico Lobos. Now the Lobos are 2-0 for the first time since 2005. Yeah. And that already totals the win total for the past two seasons for their football team. Yeah, pretty bad, but it gets worse. Tomorrow, our Fightin' Texas Aggies line up against New Mexico for the fifth time in school history. In the past four meetings, we've beaten the New Mexico Lobos by an average of 46 points. But Aggs, you know, let me slow down here. You know, everyone's talking about how great they looked last week against, you know, that high school team that they lined up against, you know, and some quarterback that they have had 381 yards and three touchdowns. But Aggs, let me tell you, we don't need to worry about that quarterback because we're already all too familiar with him. You see, the Lobos are led by Terry Wilson. You might be thinking, man, that sounds familiar. Terry Wilson was the quarterback of the Kentucky Wildcats, who were overrated and ranked number 13th back in 2018, came right here to Kyle Field and lost in a heartbreaking overtime game. In that game, Terry Wilson was held to 112 yards of total offense, went 3-for-12 on third downs, had a disgusting quarterback rating of 11.5, and our Wrecking Crew defense sacked him six times. Now we're thinking the same thing. Why would Terry Wilson want to come back to Kyle Field? We've been thinking about it all week, and we have no idea, but I'll tell you what we do know. Tomorrow, when Terry Wilson lines up against the Wrecking Crew defense and has to play in front of the greatest college stadium, the 12th man, it's going to be a hell of a lot worse than it was in 2018. Let's have a Fightin' Texas Aggie Yell practice. What are the best 4 years of a New Mexico Lobos life? The third grade, Army. Got a little story for you, Ags. There's this Nilly Willy, Hanky Panky, Slut Pea Brain, New Mexico Lobo. Well, that Lobo's lifelong dream was become a helicopter pilot. So he sought out the best instructor he could find. Well, he came across the world-renowned helicopter pilot by the name of Old Rock the Good Ag. Now, bright and early that next morning, that Lobo showed up at Old Rock's flight school. And after about 23 hours of instruction time, that sorry Lobo told Old Rock that he was ready to take it out for a spin. Now, Old Rock's only request was that he radio him every 1,000 feet to make sure everything was okay. So at 1,000 feet, he radioed in and said everything was just fine. And at 2,000 feet, he radioed in and said everything was just fine. I'm just getting a little cold up here, Rock. And right as he was about to reach 2,023 feet, that helicopter began to drop out of the sky. It crashed into the ground, and the helicopter was ruined. But somehow, miraculously, that half-wit Lobo came out unscathed. Old Rock ran up to him and said, "Everything is fine. What the hell happened?" And that Lobo, dazed and confused, said to Old Rock, "Rock, I'm sorry. I was just getting a little cold up there. So I set off the giant fan, and that's exactly what we're going to do to Max. We're going to beat the ever-living, ever-loving, compound, complex, Fightin Takes Aggie, Zach Calzada, Fightin Takes Aggie, and Jimbo We Trust. Fightin Takes Aggie, we ain't done yet. We're going to beat the Fightin Takes Aggie class of 2023 hell at New Mexico."
Thank you. why did the New Mexico football team cross the road? Because with our defense, it was a hell of a lot easier than crossing the goal line. Army. Army. I've got a little story for you, Ags. See, there was this nilly-willy, useless, tangle whisker, New Mexico Lobo. And all he wanted to be was an engineer. So after graduating from a school that nobody's heard about and earning his napkin diploma, his first job was to pour some concrete. The only issue was this Lobo was pretty stupid. So he had to call in his boss, who was none other than O-Rock, the good egg. Now O-Rock had gone to school at the best college in the world, Texas A&M. So he knew how to do what this Lobo wanted to do with his eyes shut. So whenever that nasty, tick-ridden, worthless Lobo needed help, he knew O-Rock was the man for the job. And this Lobo's job was to pour about 22 yards of concrete. And he somehow needed to make it about as smooth as his brain. Well, O-Rock walked out to that mess that Lobo created and shook his head and said, "Well, son, you might as well go check and see if it's dry." Well, that dumb Lobo walked out on the wet cement and got himself good and stuck about waist-deep in concrete. O-Rock couldn't help but laugh, shook his head, said, "Well, at least you can do half this job right. Guess I'll have to do the other half myself." And then he topped him off with another 22 yards of concrete. And that's exactly what we're going to do to him, Ags. We're going to beat the ever-living, ever-loving, compound, complex, Fightin' Texas Aggie wrecking crew, Fightin' Texas Aggie band, Fightin' Texas Aggie Parsons Mountain Cavalry. We're going to beat the Fightin' Texas Aggie class of 2022 hell out of those New Mexico Lobos.
Howdy, Army! Now, before we get to everyone's personal favorite yell, beat the hell, we're going to go over a yell that we're going to start using a lot more just to be sure, you know, that we are representing Texas A&M at the highest level at all times. And we're going to go over the yell, "Horses laugh." So whenever we disagree with something here at Texas A&M, now look for me and the guys to be passing back, "Horses laugh." All right, that's the way we separate ourselves from any other school in the world. And look no further than last week. Look at how bad Colorado looked. On national television, people talking about how horrible and trashy they looked. Nobody should ever leave Texas A&M saying something like that, all right? We don't chant vulgarities. We don't do any of that crap, all right? And if you don't like it, go to Austin, all right?
Pass it back, guys.
Rip, 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 rip.
Aggie or me?
All right, so me and the guys were studying this. We're going to go with one, so we're just going to go beat the hell out of New Mexico. All right? So we're going to do one more time so that we're perfect for tomorrow when we actually beat the hell out of New Mexico.
Howdy, Army!
Ags, I want to thank y'all so much for being here tonight. All right, this group right here is the heart and soul of Texas A&M. Y'all are the people that are keeping the spirit of Aggieland alive and well. You're holding on to traditions that set us apart, and you're diving deep in what it means to be a member of the 12th man. And with all that comes a lot of responsibility. All right, y'all are leaders, because I promise y'all, y'all aren't the fools doing the dumb crap in the stands, all right? This is a group of good eggs. This is a group that corrects people in the stands. This is a group that holds their fellow ag accountable. Ags, here at Texas A&M, we don't boo, we don't chant vulgarities at each other or at anything, all right? I've never seen a ref change the call because you decided to cuss at him or boo. You look like Colorado, you look like every other school in the world. We don't do that here. We're different. We're better. Look around. No other school in the world can do what we're doing right now. And if you still disagree, and after you all tomorrow, the good eggs tell them, hey, we don't do that. And they say, nah, we do that. You send them down right over here to talk to me. And when they do, I'll personally buy their bus ticket to Austin, Texas, so you're going to do all that dumb crap at TU with all those sorry people.